G'day guys, welcome to today's vlog. About to head out, gonna do some thrifting again today. I'm basically ready to go. Just about to hop in the car and head off. So I just pulled up to the first little town that I'm gonna hit up some thrifts at. We have a super vlogger over here. Check out this dude. Must be like news crew or something. He's vlogging hardcore, this dude. I think there was a break in here at this store. He's recording it. There's glass everywhere. So I just went into a secondhand shop yard thing. And there's three vintage bikes there. Going to the ATM to get some cash to pay for them right now, but the deal is done. I'll show you guys soon. I'm grinding that currency coming, I'm sexing the money. I'm shining, I'm certainly stunning. Them bros call me cunning. I know they don't know me, but after my show and they tell me it's nothing. Tomorrow ain't promised, I live my life honest with no interruptions. Percussions, I'm living and learning. Working and earning and sharing my sermon. And brothers feel threatened, but that don't concern me. I'm way too high up for them birds to deter me. Repercussions, I'm living and learning. Alright guys, so I managed to fit all three in there. There's a Melbourne Star one, which is this yellow one. It's also a Cyclops one. This is this really cool blue color one. I think I might keep that one for myself. And then we have a Roadmaster down here as well. 20 bucks for each bike. All right guys, so I'm inside here, still at this place. Just digging around in here. Found a Mac Pack, Guinness Genesis or whatever, hiking bag. Don't know how much they got on this, but I might get it. So I just got out of that place. They had some really cool stuff. So I picked up all those three bikes back there. They're looking at about 100 bucks per bike probably. So that's pretty cool. And I'm thinking of keeping the really cool blue colored one. That's like a sick blue color. So I might ride that for a bit. They need a little bit of tweaking here and there to get them up and running. But I also did pop on that bag. I asked her, would you take $5? And she said, yeah. Then we also got t-shirt here as well in another thrift just down the road here. Who is it? Magilla Gorilla. This is a vintage one from 1992, I think. 1994. And it's a Bonds brand one. This was a $5 tee, $4 tee, I think. Maybe 50 bucks there. So I just popped into the thrift, which is right beside me here. I picked up two things, however, I didn't take my phone with me, so I didn't get to do my research to just guarantee that the items were gonna be profitable. But still, I still think I'm onto some good ones here because I paid like $3 per item here. So the piece we have here is a Rangers NHL Reebok, but it's youth. Size extra large, so it could be like an adult small maybe, or extra small, but I saw an adult one's going for like 50 plus before I even went into this thrift, so I just knew that already. Then the other item, I don't know what I'm going to get for this, but it is a vintage Melbourne Cup Flemington 1996 t-shirt, vintage piece right here. This was $3 and that one was $3. The shirt could bring 20 to 30, but I'll just have to do some research when I get home. Also, back at that other place where I picked up these three bikes, there was a vintage retro BMX frame with handlebars there, and they were still processing it, so they were halfway done with putting it out still, and they eventually told me that it was worth 50 bucks. They were asking 50, and that could be totally worth it, but my knowledge on retro BMXs isn't all that good. I did sell a retro Haro frame for a couple hundred bucks. So I'm thinking it's still worth something, but I just don't know enough about it to buy it. And 50 bucks is a little too much for me. But I see retro frames going for $200 plus. So I might go back and get it another day. We'll see. I've got their card so I can check it out a bit later on if it's still there. But even if on the lowest end, I could probably sell it for 80 bucks or so. So I don't know why I just don't go and get it. But anyway, let's keep going on to some more thrifts. I think I've done pretty well already today, and I've just stopped at the first town. So I just popped into a Salvo's here, guys. Always find something in Salvo's. I freaking love this Salvo's. I picked up a Barber jacket. I believe it's a women's jacket because of the sizing. It's US 12. Correct me if I'm wrong there. I had 20 bucks on this and I got $7 off because I'm a club card member and I've just been saving points up. So I spent that. So I paid about 13 bucks for this jacket, and it could be upwards to 80 bucks or so. So I've done pretty well for like an hour and a half or so of work, so I think I'm just gonna finish up and head back home, work on getting this stuff listed. Kinda similar to yesterday. We'll see what else we'll do. And when I get home, I might show you guys what sold today. And then, yeah, I don't know what else I have planned.
Okay guys, so I just got home an hour or so ago, just been doing some housework, cleaned up the house a bit. I did vacuuming, I did the dishes, I did the washing, I did basically everything that needed to be done. Right now though, I'm going to go back out to the car and I'm going to get the three bikes out. I'm going to show you guys a bit of a closer look at those bikes and we'll have a look at them and see what specific bikes they are. So let's do that now. Okay guys, so I managed to bring the three bikes out the back. So as you can see, we've just got them over there. But I'm going to bring them over, talk to you guys about them individually. Alright, so the first one we have here is a 10-speed GX Sports Roadmaster vintage bike. Have in mind that I paid 20 bucks for each bike here. They had $25 on each one and I said, would you do 20 for each bike if I brought all three of them? So it worked out to be 60 bucks. It has some rust, like up here and stuff. And up there, but I think it's mostly just surface, so should be able to clean up all right. And it's sitting at about $100 to $150 bike there. It's not the best brand, but still it's not bad. All right, so the next one we have here is Melvin Star Superstar. This one's in a bit better nick. These bikes are a little rough, they just need a little bit of tweaking here and there to get them up and running, but again, 20 for this one. It's probably like $100 and $150 bike, somewhere around there again. But I saved the best to last. This is my favorite and I'm probably gonna keep it for myself. Do you guys hear this? Ready? Love that sound. So here we have a Cyclops Dran in the awesome, beautiful blue. Torquay's blue, I think it is. That's why I like this bike. It's just like the colors of it. It's just awesome. So this is a keeper. Paid 20 for this one, but I've got to do some research on this one to figure out what sort of price I could get for it if and when I do want to sell it. Again, like I guess, they're all about in the range of $100 to $150. Couldn't particularly find anything sold related to the Cyclops behind me, but I could probably try and get $200 if I was going to sell it, just because of the colors. People dig the retro colors on these bikes. What I'm going to do is just spend a couple of minutes just adjusting the bikes and getting them set up to be rideable. As you can see, this one here has a bit of a off steering, so I'm just going to straighten that up. All right, so they're basically all fixed up. The Roadmaster is all good, just adjusted everything to make it rideable. The Cyclops out the back there is ready for me to ride it. However, the Melvin Star does have a flat. I pumped up all the tires, all seem to be good except that rear on the yellow Melvin Star, which I'll get replaced in the next couple of days or so. I haven't ridden them yet, so I'm not sure how they ride, but I just adjusted the seats and the handlebars to suit myself. I might give that blue one a ride in the next couple of days or so. So I'm gonna wait until it gets a little bit later, until it gets a little darker. It's too much of direct sunlight at the moment, so I'm just gonna wait until it comes a bit later to take the photos for the bikes. But before I get started on listing what I have here, I'm gonna get a shipment out of what I sold. I have an hour or so until the post office closes, so let's get them out. All right, how's the lighting? Is that better? Let's get out what we sold. First item is a JanSport bag. This one sold for $27 plus shipping. Next one was a Australians Do It Better vintage t-shirt, TP6. I only sold this one for $18.50. It was sitting around for a bit. I had it on Etsy as well, but decided to get rid of it, get my money back plus a little bit. And it's going out the door for $18.50. Next sale was another Cox Plate hat. Sold for 25 bucks plus postage. For 10 bucks, we sold a Black Wolf bag. This one here. Let's make sure there's nothing in there because I was using this. Pen. All right, that passes the test. And the last item that I'm sending out today is a Portsman ladies dress from the bulk lot of ladies clothes that I got. Sold this one for $15 plus shipping. I gotta get out of here and turn this light off. It's a bloody ripper of a day outside. It's pretty hot today and this light is not helping. Me and Susie just walking down to the post office. Gonna get these parcels out. Guys, finally the time has come. We found one of Joey's mates. Say hello, Joey. Oh, he's
god.
So I made it back home. I just got dinner on the go. That is in there cooking away. List or wash car? List or wash car? I'm gonna wash the car and then I'll list. Hey man. This ain't to nobody in particular. Car's done. We also cleaned out the birdie cages. Birdie. Hey birdie. My favorite's that blue one.
What blue one?
Yeah.
What is it? Retro.
It's a Cyclops. Dinner's ready. Come and get it. All right, so I got to drop Shania off. I'm driving her to a friend's party.
Hey.
She needs to be there very soon, like in 20 minutes or so. And while I'm down there, I'm thinking to go to a Savers. All right, guys, so I'm in the Savers here. I think I'm going to get this bag here. It's the same brand as the jacket that I'm wearing, the Mountain Designs Australia Odyssey 2. With an Australia embroidery emblem thing there. Hiking bag for $5 or so. I think I might get this. Might be able to sell it for maybe 50, I don't know. I'm gonna see, I might keep it for myself. We'll see. Also think I might pop on this. Rhodes and Beckett suit for $19. Comps are looking okay on this one. Just gonna go over it and check to see if there's any faults. I didn't pop on the suit because if a suit normally has any flaws whatsoever, I'm not gonna get it. So I just passed up on it. Got the bag. And let's get home. So I'm not sure if you can see me that well inside the car. It's pretty dark. It's hit about 8:30 Friday night tonight and it is chockers. It is just booming. Everybody's out and about. I did pop on some more items that I want to show you guys. It's an experiment, so hopefully this goes all right. Let's just see how we go. I picked up three of these items. They're John Lennon English Laundry t-shirts, or button front shirts, I should say. I ended up paying $40 per shirt. These have sold on the eBay sold listings for about $139.95 per shirt, free shipping. So I'm going to give it a crack and see how I go. Maybe bring the price down a little bit to about $120 per shirt. Then if I sell it, take out how much I paid for each shirt, it'll come down to about $80 to $90 take away fees. And I should be making about $70 per shirt if it goes well. It is a risk. And I was just going back and forth trying to just work out the calculations and stuff. I'm not sure if it's too dark here. However, it seems like I'm going to come out on top, maybe double my money or a bit more. So make $40 or $70 depending on each one. I picked up different colors and also sizes as well, just to experiment and see how we go with this. Also, I should mention they are brand new with tags. It's a John Lennon English Laundry Edition shirt. I'm thinking there's some desire here for these items. They may be rare. So let's just see how we go with them. So I got three of those shirts. And then I also picked up some pants as well. Some Brooks Brothers pants with the palm trees going on there. A nice blue color. These are also brand new with tags. And I paid $7 for these ones. So I'm thinking 40 to 50 for those. We'll see how we go with those. You guys updated if I make any sales on these items. But I'm gonna call it a night. It is 8:30, still hustling. No, just kidding. Anyway, I'm gonna head back home now, I think. I just got done taking some photos of the items that I picked up today, and I've already listed those English Laundry shirts that I picked up because I wanna test the waters with those and see how they go. But that is it for today's vlog. I'm gonna keep listing, get some more work done. It is getting pretty late, it's around 10:30. I'm gonna edit this vlog as well, get it uploaded. But yeah, I'll see you guys in tomorrow's vlog. Thanks for coming along today and watching. Give it a thumbs up. Really appreciate it. And I'll see you guys in tomorrow's one. Bye.